You've put your data into an Excel table, but now when you try to filter by one of the columns, that is, hide and unhide data rows based on some criteria, it's not working, meaning that data you expect to be hidden is still showing up, or that data you expect to be visible is not being displayed. Let's move through the three most common culprits and see if we can get things working again. The first thing to look at is the scroll bar. It could be that your filtered data is not showing up because you had scrolled down the worksheet before you applied the filter. This is likely to be the case if you've used the freeze panes feature on the view tab of the ribbon. Excel will not automatically adjust the window scroll based on your filter, so make sure the scroll bar is scrolled to the top, especially if your filter will only display a small number of rows. The second thing to look for is competing filters. To check this one, it's easiest if you start by making sure you're scrolled up to the top of the worksheet. Remember that filters work in an AND way, meaning that Excel will only show you the table data that meets the criteria of all of the filters at the same time. If you know you've got some table data that you think should be showing up, but it's not, be sure to check that none of the other columns have a filter on that means those criteria might be hiding the data row that you expect to see. Looking at the header row, you'll know that a filter has been set for a column if that column's button has a little funnel image on it. That's different from the sort indicator, which is the little vertical arrow, which you don't need to worry about here. If you've left a previously used column filter on by mistake, simply expand the Sort and Filter menu for that column and select the Clear Filter option. You should see that the funnel has been removed from that headers button. Then, double-check your filter criteria in any remaining filters. If this was the problem, you should now see the data you expect. The third thing to look for is where Excel thinks your data table ends, which might not be where you think it ends. And that can mean that data that you think should be hidden by a filter is still visible. To see if this is your problem, go to the bottom row of the data on this worksheet and then take a look at the rightmost cell of that bottommost row. Do you see a little chevron in the bottom right? If so, then your data is included in the table and this is not your problem. If that chevron is not there, you can fix this manually. First, make sure that any filters you had on are cleared. And then find where Excel thinks your data table ends. If you've been using banded rows in your table, the end of the banded rows is an easy thing to look for. If you're comfortable using keyboard shortcuts, select the rightmost cell of your bottom row of data, and then use the keyboard keys Control plus up arrow to find what Excel thinks is the last row of the table. You'll know you're in the right place when you see that chevron on that row. To manually extend the table to include all of your data, select any cell that's not the one with the chevron, like the one right next to it, and then move your mouse over the chevron. Your cursor will look like a diagonal arrow when you're in the right spot. Left-click and drag down until you've moved the chevron all the way down to the bottom of your data. The filter should now apply to all of the data on the worksheet because all of your data is now recognized by Excel as part of the table. If this general information video did not solve your Excel table problem, or you'd like other help working with data in Excel, drop a comment below, or find me, Barbara Olsavsky, the owner and data strategist at Blou Designs, on LinkedIn or at bluedesigns.com. Thank you for watching.